1965, Pete Townshend wrote one of the most famous lines in rock and roll history, "Hope I die before I get old." Well, Pete got old, and I'm not sure what he meant by that line, but he may have been talking about the deterioration that many of us see over time. Many people would talk about aging, in fact, as a deterioration of our bodies, a deterioration of those tissues, as inevitable as the rusting of a wagon out in the yard. What if we were to think about aging in a different way? What if we were to think about aging not according to the diseases of aging, but think about aging as a disease itself? What if we were to think not about aging as an inevitable process, but rather as a biological a process that could be addressed with specific biological events, and we could identify those specific biological events and perhaps change them or alter them? The effects of aging are obvious, and those effects are just that, effects. But what causes these changes? What is the central biological mechanism that may explain aging in all organisms? Well, scientists have been looking at this for more than 10 years, and they have a candidate for this master controller, and it may not surprise you to know that it's DNA. Now, DNA is the instructional code by which proteins are, the production of proteins are guided, and those proteins do pretty much everything inside of a cell. And as time passes, DNA acquires chemical modifications. The code is annotated, right? And these annotations are called epigenetic modifications. Some genes, when they are modified in this way, cause the overproduction of proteins, and other times when genes are modified in different ways, they can cause the disappearance of the production of those proteins. We now know that many of the hallmark features of aging seem to be linked to these epigenetic modifications, and this has led to a new idea about thinking, the concept of an epigenetic clock. Now, a chronological clock works the same for everyone, but an epigenetic clock, which is really just the accumulation of chemical changes on DNA over time, doesn't work the same way for everyone. These two individuals experience the passage of time in the same way, but they die at different times, at least in part, because they have different epigenetic clocks. And this is an exciting way to think about aging, because if aging is dictated by an epigenetic clock, and that clock is really just the accumulation of chemical changes, couldn't we turn back the clock by resetting those changes? That idea is called epigenetic programming. And scientists all over the world are studying it, including Juan Belmonte at the Salk Institute. Now, this work, this epigenetic reprogramming work, really centers on four genes, right? Genes which, when turned on, are capable of changing and resetting the epigenetic modifications to DNA. Now, they only normally work in stem cells. But Belmonte wondered what would happen if he could express them in all of the cells of a mouse. So he and his colleagues did just that. They made a genetically modified line of mice in which these genes could be turned on as the mouse got older, and their results were remarkable. They found that by turning on these four genes, they were able to accelerate healing following injury. They were able to slow down and even reverse some of the cellular hallmarks of aging, and importantly, extend the lifespan of these mice 30 to 35%. Research like this is going on all over the world, and if the results of this work do lead to longer-lived populations, then we'll be faced with a whole new set of issues to address. How will societies deal with longer-lived populations? How will these technologies be shared equitably? And what would be the environmental implications of a longer human lifespan? These questions will be even tougher to solve than the question of aging itself. But I believe that people like you, people who are doing and teaching and learning this science, will be at the forefront of finding the solutions to these problems. Because you're thinking about how science interacts with our environment and with our society. I think that's going to be true. Let's meet back here in 100 years, and we'll see if I'm right. Thank you.